Welcome to the course on data structures and applications. Introduction. In this course, we discuss what is a data structure, why do we need data structure, and we'll take some real life examples of data structure. A data structure is the most fundamental and building block concept in computer science. Data structure is one of the most important subjects in the computer science that need to be studied. A good knowledge of data structure a must to design and develop an efficient software systems and applications. We must have a good knowledge of data structure to implement softwares. What is a data structure? In computer science, data structure is a study of various ways of organizing data in a computer so that it can be used efficiently. We define the data structure is a study of organizing the various ways of data so that it can be used efficiently, or a data structure is a way to store and organize data in a computer so that it can be used efficiently. Why do we need data structures? It allows data to be stored in a specific manner. It allows efficient data search and retrieval. It allows to manage large amount of databases. The data structure is required to store the data in a specific way or manner, and it going to allows efficient data search and retrieval, as well as it going to manage the large amount of databases, for example the Amazon or the Flipkart, where the large amount of data need to be managed. A specific data structure decides to work for a specific problem. Now, by taking a particular problem, we need to decide what type of data structure need to be used. We deal with data all the times, and how we store, organize, and group or manage our data together matters. In our day-to-day life, we manage the lot of data. How to store the data, how to organize as per the specific requirement, and how to manage, these all going to matter in the data structures. Let us take some examples of day-to-day life. English dictionary. In the English dictionary, the words are organized in an alphabetical order, which makes the search easy. The data structure used here is the search. It takes another example, city map positions of landmarks and routes in the form of a graph. Here, we represent the landmarks and the roads of a city in the form of a graph. Again, we are using the data structure called graph to represent the landmarks and the roads of a city. Cash book is another example where we are going to maintain the accounts in the row wise as well as the column wise. Invariably, data contained in a data structure is manipulated by systematic and step-by-step procedure called an algorithm. The data contained in the data structure need to be manipulated in a proper manner, that is a systematic way, by using a procedure step by step called an algorithm. The manipulation of data structure may involve such operations. They are adding an item, searching an item, deleting an item, rearranging of data items in various ways. We need to arrange the data in a different way as per our need. Thus, data structure and algorithm are closed, linked together, and play complementary role in many applications. Hence, we can say the data structure and algorithm are, they are linked together, they are going to play a complementary role in many applications. Hence, we say the data structure and algorithm is equal to application. Thus, data structure are as an integral part of the modern operating system and compiler, The data structure is also used in database management system as well as in the data communication, where we can find the data structure application. Applications for data structures are, we are going to use data structure in digital image processing applications, in 3D design, in cryptography, we need to have the data structure, as well as in the artificial intelligence also we can find the use of data structure. Classifications. The data structures are classified broadly into two categories. One is primitive and non-primitive. The primitive are those data structures which are non-decomposable. They are integer, float, character, and pointer. All its basic data types are called primitive data structures. The non-primitive data structures again further classified into two categories. One is linear as well as non-linear. The linear in the sense that data are stored in a linear fashion, the sequential fashion. Such data structures are called the linear data structures. Example, array, stack, queue, lists, files, they comes under the linear data structures. The non-linear data structures are their non-sequential organizations. They are trees and the graphs. The data structures are divided into two types, primitive data structures as well as non-primitive data structures. The primitive data structures are the basic data structures that directly operate upon the machine instructions. They have different representations on different computers. Integers, floating point numbers, character constants, string constants, and pointers comes under this category. Non-primitive data structures are more complicated data structures and are derived from primitive data structures. They emphasize on grouping same or different data items with relationship between each data item. Arrays, lists, and files comes under this category. Non-primitive data structures are further classified into linear and non-linear data structures. The linear data structures, if elements are connected in a linear fashion by means of logically or in sequence memory locations. Example, array, list, stack, and queue. Non-linear data structures are those data structures in which data items are not arranged in a sequence. Example, graph and tree. Operations. What operation we can perform on the data structures? Traversing. The traversing is used to access each data item exactly once so that it can be processed. The another exam operation is searching, is used to find out the location of a data item if it exists in the given collection of a data items. Sorting is another operations used to arrange the data items in some order, that is in ascending or the descending order. Inserting is used to add a new data item in the given collection of a data items or the existing database. Deleting is operation used to delete an existing data items from the given collection of data items. Merging is another operation is used to combine the data items of two sorted files into a single file in the sorted form.